It can be really easy to see all the hardships and darkness the world faces and let that form our view of God. But what our view of God should be ultimately defined by is His Word and love. This accurate view of God will lead us to see God for who He truly is. Here are a few scriptures on what makes God attractive. God is all about love. 1 John 4, verses 7 through 8 says, "Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves is a child of God and knows God, but anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love." God loves us and wants us to love the people around us. If you have ever felt love and wanted to love someone else, you're understanding who God is. God is a father to us. He wants a relationship with us and enjoys our company. God reveals truth about ourselves. Jeremiah 17, verses 9 through 10 says, "The human heart is the most deceitful of all things and desperately wicked. Who really knows how bad it is? But I, the Lord, search all hearts and examine secret motives. I give all people their due rewards according to what their actions deserve." Truth can be a difficult thing to find, understand, or admit, but God desires to see our hearts and what motivates us. God can see our hearts better than we can and will reward us by our heart rather than what we look like on the outside. God wants us to feel forgiveness. Hebrews 10, verse 22 says, "We come closer to God and approach Him with an open heart, fully convinced by faith that nothing will keep us at a distance from Him. For our hearts have been sprinkled with blood to remove impurity, and we have been freed from an accusing conscience, and now we are clean, unstained, and presentable to God inside and out." God wants us to have a clear conscience. He doesn't want us to be motivated by guilt or fear, but to be free from a heavy heart. What do you feel guilty about that you don't feel forgiven for? God gives us wisdom. James 1 verse 5, he says, "And if anyone longs to be wise, ask God for wisdom, and He will give it. He won't see your lack of wisdom as an opportunity to scold you over your failures, and He will overwhelm your failures with His generous grace." God desires for us to gain wisdom because it will help us mature and understand who He is. God will not belittle you or hold any failures against you, but wants to give you the wisdom you need to live a good life. God meets a need we can't describe. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 11 says, "He has made everything beautiful and appropriate in its time. He has also planted eternity, a sense of divine purpose, in the human heart, a mysterious longing which nothing under the sun can satisfy except God. Yet man cannot find out, comprehend, grasp what God has done, His overall plan, from the beginning to the end." God has set in every person's heart a sense of eternity or need for purpose that nothing but Him can satisfy. When we feel alone, broken, or lost, our hearts are longing to be with God. Pause and reflect. What forms your view of who God is? Is it your life experiences, what people say, or the Bible? What makes God attractive to you? Do you want to have a relationship with God to get to know Him better? For more studies, check out our channel or go to our website at deepspirituality.com.